A week of deprivation, probably gonna be okay. A month of deprivation, not gonna mess your metabolism up, especially if you have a lot of weight to lose. But month after month after month, your metabolism will slow down and your body will become less efficient at burning fat. Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I am going to address the most common question on fasting, which is, won't it slow down my metabolism? So many people have asked us that. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use fasting to speed up your metabolism and ways in which you can actually use fasting. Not that you'd want to, but there's ways that you can use fasting that will slow down your metabolism. So we want you to avoid those ways. Welcome, by the way, if you are new to my channel, I am delivering all things fasting to you. So all the things you need to know to build a fasting lifestyle, I am delivering to you here on this station. And if you are new, please subscribe, hit the notification button. Every Thursday, I go live and answer your questions. And as always, if you guys love this video, send it out into the world. I am a woman on a mission. I am gearing in 2021 to get 1 million people on this channel learning how to build a fasting lifestyle. So as always, I hope this information helps. And if you love it, send it out into the world. Okay, intermittent fasting, fasting in general, doesn't it slow your metabolism down? I mean, didn't we learn that you got to eat 6 meals a day to speed your metabolism up? This doesn't make sense that if I don't eat, that my metabolism speeds up. So I want to start off by giving you an analogy that I think really helps you understand what fasting does. And I say this to my Academy members all the time. If you and I were in a cabin in the woods and winter was coming and they delivered a whole bunch of firewood and they said, you're set for winter. You have a wood burning stove inside the cabin to keep you warm. You got a huge pile of firewood out there. Burn away. You're going to be fine to stay warm all winter. No problem. We would probably look out the window and be like, yeah, it's cold in here. Let's get some firewood in. And we'd start filling that stove and burning the wood over and over and over again. And we would do it with freedom and not care about it. And then one day we look out there, it's a long winter. It's still very cold and the pile has gotten very small. What would happen is we would intellectually say, we better slow down the burning of this wood or we're going to completely run out and then we won't have any heat inside the cabin. This is what's happening to your body. So when you guys come to fasting, you have all this stored sugar that you stored years ago. So when you go into these fasted states, your body becomes very, very efficient at burning all that stored sugar and you start dropping weight. And you're like, this is amazing. Oh my God, fasting's incredible. I'm going to keep fasting. And so you fast more. And so many, I mean, we see it here on my channel all the time. So many of you guys do 1 meal a day where you're like, God, and you know, with fasting, the hardest part is we don't get hungry. So it's easy to go 24 hours without eating. So you get in this sort of mentality of fasting's better than food. And you start to shorten your window for eating. And the longer you do that, if you do not vary your fast, if you don't have some feast days, eventually your metabolism is going to do what we would do in the cabin when the wood pile went low. Your metabolism is going to go, wait a second, there's not a lot of food coming here, so I better make sure that I slow down my metabolism so that I don't run out of stored sugar. That's literally what it's thinking. So there's a couple of tricks to make sure that that doesn't happen. First trick, vary your fast. Some days you go 15 hours, some days you go 24, some days you do a 48 hours, some days you don't fast. So you're fooling your body. It never really knows. It would be like us, some days we're having one log in the stove, other days we have 3 logs in the stove. So instead of always demanding that your body go after the stored glucose, you're surprising it a little bit by varying it. That will really help your metabolism. Second thing that I want to tell you is that when you eat, eat. So there's a lot of research out there and a lot of critics on fasting who are looking at the science that says calorie restriction causes this problem. Calorie restriction causes that problem. Women and hormones. This is a common thing I'm hearing about women and hormones. Women shouldn't fast because calorie restriction is no good for a woman's hormonal health. Okay, fasting is not calorie restriction. You have a time when you eat and you have a time when you fast. So if you are at the weight you want to be at, or if you want to gain weight per se, or you don't want to get stuck with your weight loss efforts, make sure that you're not staying in that low calorie, low keto, low carb state day after day with your fast. That is the fastest way to slow the metabolism down, is to be in these longer fasts every day and then be in restriction when you eat. So this is why we talk about, how do you use food to build hormones? How do you use food to do some protein loading? There is a feast, famine, cycling I'm trying to teach you guys here. So this really, the tip there is to make sure when you eat, and that you're not in deprivation day after day. A week of deprivation, probably gonna be okay. A month of deprivation, not gonna mess your metabolism up, especially if you have a lot of weight to lose. But month after month after month, your metabolism will slow down and your body will become less efficient at burning fat. So we don't want that to happen. So the key to the metabolism, and this is really, I want to like sum up this concept, is if you don't want your metabolism to slow down, you want to vary your fasts. And when you eat, you want to make sure you don't stay in deprivation all the time. I'm not saying low keto is bad. I'm not saying carnivore is bad. I'm just saying don't be in deprivation. Make sure you're varying fasts. Make sure you're leaning into some feast days. Don't fast other days. That in and out of a fasting lifestyle is what really gets you lean, gets you strong, and gets you healthy again. So there you go. That's the skinny on what happens with fasting and your metabolism. As always, if this helps, let me know. We do have a new reset coming up. It's called the Forever Young Reset, Forever Immune. We mixed some things up. It's Forever Immune. And I've taken all the principles of all of our resets last year, our immune building principles, our fat burning principles, our anti-aging principles, and I've put it together in a 19-day program. We'd love to have you join us. So if you want to join us in that, just put Forever Immune in the comments. And let's do this, because this will be fun. If you've had great results with fasting, losing weight, or building muscle, let us know in the comments. We are a community here on YouTube. So we want to hear from you and what results you've gotten with these principles. So as always, I hope that helps.